Let's go on to chapter number 5 now, right? That is of class 11, NEET 5.1, States of Matter. Ab States of Matter ki ek agar sirf hum introduction kare, first of all, you will definitely get one question from this. You can even get two. Aur zyada aapne concentrate is section pe kiske upar karna hai, on all the laws and the numericals, right? Conceptual question is se kam aata, you're lucky if you get any question on the liquid state, viscosity ke upar ya surface tension ke upar, koi agar question aa jaye to you're lucky enough. But mostly you want to get questions on either of the laws, right? So when we're talking of states of matter, if we're just taking a general introduction over here, so states of matter mein hume pata hai ki physically hum classify karte hai matter ko into solid, liquid and gaseous state. Theek? Solids, they are rigid because the molecules, they are going to be very closely packed. Liquids, they are fluids because molecules, they are a little far away. And gases, they are compressible as the molecules, they are going to be very, very far away from each other. The intermolecular forces of attraction, that is going to be maximum in case of solids and it is going to be minimum in case of gases. Solids wala jo chapter hai wo aapka, agar aap competition wali chemistry padho to solid state isi ke saath linked hai in this particular states of matter only, but we are going to study it at a separate part with class 12 wala jo portion hum karenge, theek hai? So let's go on to the states of matter over here. When we talking of states of matter, we say that whenever matter mein hum bol rahe hain ki solid, liquid or gases mein, there are forces of attraction which are present. What are these forces of attraction? The intermolecular forces of attraction which are going to be present. The first one that is going to be London or dispersion forces, ठीक है? ये जो London या dispersion forces होते हैं, these forces of attraction, they are going to be number one, characteristics अगर हम इसके देखें, they are going to be always attractive in nature, ठीक है? And number two, जो London forces हैं, they generally are present in non-polar or you can say homoatomic molecules. जैसे for example अगर हमने iodine किया तो iodine आपको पता है the shared pair of electrons that is going to remain in the center. So because it is remaining in the center, such molecules they are going to have dispersion forces. So in this case what happens is कि there is going to be, and when we talking of क्या कहते हैं उसको dispersion forces or London forces, there is going to be an instantaneous dipole which is created. ठीक है, अब वो जो instantaneous dipole है वो create होता है due to the movement of the electrons, right? So if you dive into detail in class 11, we need not do in detail over here. There are two things which you require to know. Number one, these forces, they are always attractive in nature, and number two, that the interaction energy due to these forces जो इंटरैक्शन एनर्जी होती है, because of this, because of these forces, that is equal to or directly proportional to 1 upon r raised to power 6, where r that is going to be the radius, ठीक है? So it is proportional to यहाँ पे equal to की जगह if we take the sign, it is proportional to 1 upon r raised to power 6, ठीक है? So these are the London forces. Now these forces, they are going to depend upon the following factors. Number one, they will depend upon the size of the molecule. So in case if we're saying large molecules, the large molecules, it is said they have diffused cloud, electron cloud. So if they're going to have diffused electron cloud, there is going to be great chances of distortion, and as a result of which the forces of attraction, they are going to be greater. So size of the molecules, itna bada size, utne hi forces of attraction, they are going to be more. So size of the molecules, that is going to be directly proportional to the London forces. Second, it will depend upon the number of electrons which are present in an atom. अब जितने ज़्यादा electrons होंगे, उतना ही क्या होगा? Greater chances of distortion of electron cloud. और जितना distortion होता है, उतने ही forces of attraction ज़्यादा होंगे. So again, they are going to be directly proportional to Nundinian forces. And thirdly, we have over here the molecular structure. The molecular structure. So, shape of the molecules, they are going to also have a significant effect on the so forces of attraction over here. It is generally seen ki agar jaise jaise branching hoti rehti hai, waise waise the what is happening to the chain, it is becoming more compact. Aur agar wo zyada compact hogi, to in that case the surface area that will decrease and the London forces they will also decrease. ठीक है? So longer chain, more surface area, more is going to be the London forces. Branch chain, less surface area and less is going to be the London forces. ठीक है? Second type of forces which we have, they are known as dipole-dipole interactions. Dipole-dipole interactions क्या हुए? These are going to be present due to a dipole which is created in a molecule. So generally they are present in those molecules which have difference in electronegativities between the two atoms. So polar molecules, or we can say they are present in heteroatomic. Jaise for example, if we are taking HCl, right? We know over here chlorine is more electronegative, so it is going to attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself. This is a slight negative charge aa gaya, this is a slight positive charge aa gaya. Theek hai? So this is going to create a dipole over moment over here. Ye wala chloride kya karega? Ye agle ke hydrogen ko apni taraf ko attract karega agle molecule ke. To is tarah se the forces of attraction they start developing over here due to the dipole which is created in the molecules. Now again we say that these are going to be attractive forces. Okay, these are going to be attractive forces, and when we are looking at the interaction energy over here, the interaction energy can be classified according to the movement of the molecules. Now if the atom that is at stationary state, it is seen that if it is at a stationary state, the interaction energy that is going to be inversely proportional to 1 upon r cube. But if the molecule is in motion, in that case the interaction energy that is inversely proportional to 1 upon r raised to power 6. So yahan pe aapko question ye ek bar hi aaya hua hai ki stationary state mein dipole dipole interaction energy jo hai wo radius ke sath kaise vary karti hai. So stationary weight is 1 upon r cube. Rest you will remember that all of them, whether we are doing London forces, whether we are doing dipole-dipole, whether we will do dipole-induced dipole, in all the cases, it is going to be inversely proportional to 1 upon r6. Okay? So in dipole-dipole, mein stationary state mein, it is going to be directly inversely proportional to 1 upon r cube. Okay? So ye aapko ispe, ye ek question hai jo ki hume aa sakta hai. Then the next kind of forces which we are going to discuss, they are dipole-induced dipole. Next one which we have, that is dipole-induced dipole. These types of forces of attraction, they are going to occur between one polar and the other one non-polar. ठीक है? So एक जो polar होता है, वो non-polar में डायपोल को इंड्यूस कर देता है, जिसकी वजह से देयर इज गोइंग टू बी फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन व्हिच आर गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस ओवर हियर. नाउ दीज फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन दे आर आल्सो गोइंग टू बी अट्रैक्टिव, ऑलवेज अट्रैक्टिव. ठीक है? और इसकी जो इंटरैक्शन एनर्जी होगी, एज आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू, दैट विल बी इक्वल टू व्हाट? इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1 अपॉन r6. Right? Now these three forces, they are collectively known as the van der Waal forces of attraction. So aapko in general pata hai ki van der Waal forces of attraction mein agar size increase hota hai to van der Waal forces of attraction increase hote hain, agar branching increase hoti hai to van der Waal forces of attraction decrease hote hain. ठीक है. सो दिस इज व्हाट द थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस आर. द फोर्थ टाइप व्हिच वी हैव दैट इज द हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड व्हिच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन आवर लास्ट क्लास. केमिकल बॉन्डिंग में हमने ऑलरेडी इसको डिस्कस कर लिया है. सो हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड क्या होता है? इट इज द बॉन्ड बिटवीन हाइड्रोजन एंड अ हाईली इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एलिमेंट. ठीक है. Now over here when we talking of hydrogen bond, I told you yesterday ki do tarah ke hote hain. One is intermolecular and the other one that is going to be intramolecular hydrogen bond. Intermolecular hydrogen bond mein the boiling point that is going to increase, the solubilities they are also going to increase. ठीक है. Intramolecular mein itna koi zyada farak in cheezon ke upar nahi padta. To isse se aapko questions kaise aa sakte hain ki amongst the following which will have amongst the hydrides of group 15 which will have the highest boiling point. So aapko pata hai ki isme NH3 that is going to have the highest boiling point because of hydrogen bonding. Aapne 12th pe padh liya hai already, right? Par uske baad fir uske jo trend rehta hai uska, that is ki NH3 ka boiling point zyada hai, fir PH3 ka, aur fir uske baad it keeps on increasing down the group. So you can also get trend questions from here. ठीक है. Why does this happen? That is because इसमें hydrogen bonding है और उससे नीचे क्या हो रहा है? The size that is increasing and hence the van der Waals forces of attraction they are going to increase and hence the boiling point also they are going to increase. So this is the kind of question which you can get from here. Similarly, when we are taking halogen acids of group 17, so उसमें HF जो है that is going to have the highest boiling point. फिर उसके बाद HCl, HCl के बाद HBr और HBr के बाद HI. Now why this trend is being followed? Same reason. HF has hydrogen bonding. उसके बाद size keeps on increasing. Van der Waals forces will keep on increasing. And as a result of which the forces of attraction they will keep on increasing. ठीक है. Now when we talking of over here gases, the first state which we are going to do that is going to be the gas. Now gas का जो एक सबसे बड़ी property है now when we doing gases की एक जो सबसे बड़ी property है that is going to be compressibility. ठीक है. Why compressibility? Because the molecules in the gas they are very far apart. तो जब हम उसके ऊपर प्रेशर अप्लाई करते हैं द मॉलिक्यूल्स दे कम क्लोजर. ठीक है. सो इट मींस दैट अबाउट द गैस देयर आर टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स व्हिच आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वन इज गोइंग टू बी द प्रेशर ऑफ द गैस. व्हाई द गैस इज एक्सर्टिंग प्रेशर? बिकॉज द मॉलिक्यूल्स दे आर फ्री टू मूव अबाउट. दे कोलाइड विद ईच अदर एंड दे आल्सो कोलाइड विद द वॉल्स ऑफ द कंटेनर. दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई दे आर गोइंग टू एक्सर्ट प्रेशर. ठीक है. एंड द सेकेंड वन इज गोइंग टू बी द वॉल्यूम. बिकॉज यू नो कि उसके जो मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं वो एकदम से जैसे ही आप एक परफ्यूम की बॉटल खोलते हो तो यू कैन स्मेल ऑल अराउंड. दैट इज बिकॉज उसके जो मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं वो एकदम से डिस्पर्स हो जाते हैं एंड दे हैव द टेंडेंसी टू ऑक्यूपाई द इंटायर वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ रूम. ठीक है. सो इट मीन्स द टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स व्हिच आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑफ द गैसेस. द फर्स्ट वन व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेशर. इट हैज वेरी लेस मास ओवर हियर एंड इट इज गोइंग टू हैव वेरी लेस डेंसिटी ऑल्सो. ओके. सो प्रेशर जो होता है इसके आपको कन्वर्जन फैक्टर्स आने जरूरी है. बिकॉज जब हम लोग गैस इक्वेशन के क्वेश्चंस करेंगे या हम लोग किसी भी लॉ के क्वेश्चंस करेंगे तो वहां पे आपको जो ऑप्शंस दे रखी होती है दे आर गिवन इन डिफरेंट यूनिट्स ऑफ प्रेशर व्हिच यू नीड टू इंटरप्रेट. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द यूनिट्स ऑफ प्रेशर ओवर हियर. द फर्स्ट वन व्हिच इज गोइंग टू बी एटमॉस्फेयर. राइट. One atmosphere that is going to be equal to 1.008 bar, right? One atmosphere that is equal to 760 mm of mercury. One atmosphere that is equal to 76 centimeter. One atmosphere is equal to 760 torr, and one atmosphere is equal to 1×10^5 pascals. ठीक है. सो ये इसके कन्वर्जन फैक्टर्स जो रहते हैं दैट यू नीड टू रिमेम्बर व्हिच इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट जो आपको कहीं पे भी यूज होंगे. ठीक है. क्लियर हो गया. द सेकेंड वन व्हिच वी हैव ओवर हियर वॉल्यूम के भी कन्वर्जन फैक्टर्स आपको याद होने चाहिए. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू टेकिंग वॉल्यूम इन लीटर्स 1 liter, that is equal to 1000 centimeter cube, or it is equal to 1000 ml. It is equal to 10 raised to power minus 3 meter cube. ठीक है, और एक और होता है आपका डेसीलीटर. डेसीलीटर इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? 0.1 लीटर्स. सो इफ यू टेकिंग 1 डेसीलीटर ओवर हियर, दैट इज इक्वल टू, डेसी मींस 1/10. ठीक है, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी इक्वल टू 0.1 लीटर्स. सो दीज आर द कन्वर्जन फैक्टर्स व्हिच यू नीड टू नो अबाउट द वॉल्यूम. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद आप यहां पे यू विल कम अक्रॉस another term when we are going to do over here, that is the standard temperature pressure. Because अगर आपको numericals दिए हैं और उसपे बोला है कि the gas is at standard temperature pressure, तो उसपे आपको पता होना चाहिए कि हम लोग standard temperature क्या ले रहे हैं और हम standard pressure क्या ले रहे हैं. So standard temperature pressure पे it is going to be, the temperature is taken as 273.15 Kelvin. ठीक है, the pressure that will be taken as 1 atmosphere, right? Standard temperature pressure. एक और condition हमारे पास होती है, which is known as SADP. Now, what is SADP? This is standard ambient temperature pressure, right? At standard ambient temperature pressure, the temperature that is taken as 298 Kelvin, and the pressure that is taken as 1 bar. Okay, and to be very very exact, it is taken as 10 raised to power 5 Pascals. Okay, so these are the things which you need to remember for your calculations. So now let's go on to, as we're saying that pressure and volume and temperature, these are the three characteristics of a gas. We are going to go on to the laws, which are going to give us a relationship between all these three different variants of a gas. The first one which we have over here, that is the Boyle's law. According to Boyle's law, the pressure of a gas at constant temperature, that is going to be inversely proportional to volume, which means that as we are increasing the pressure, the volume of a gas, that is going to decrease. But provided the temperature over here, that should be constant. So if you're plotting a graph between pressure and volume, the graph of the Boyle's law, that is going to be seen like this. This is the first graph. Graphical questions भी आपको आते हैं, so this is going to be the first graph. ठीक है? इस expression को हम कैसे ले सकते हैं? कि अगर हम लोग okay, let's say that this expression can be taken as PV, that is equal to constant. ठीक है? या अगर हम दो gases compare कर रहे हैं, तो over here P1 V1, that is going to be equal to P2 V2. Okay, so numericals जो आपके आएंगे, that is going to be on this P1 V1, that is equal to P2 V2. Now, if we are taking a graphical representation between pressure and 1 by V, it is going to be a straight line. We are taking this at three different temperatures. Let's say this is T3, this is going to be T2, this is going to be T1. Okay, और यहाँ पे जो T3 की वैल्यू है, that is higher than T2, and T2 that is going to be higher than T1. So these graphical representations which we are taking over here, these are known as isotherms. Iso means constant, same, and therms means temperature over here. So if you're taking the same distinct temperature, so this is going to be known as what? They are going to be known as isotherms. Now, when we're taking this relation over here, एक और चीज़ जो हम लोग यहाँ से measure कर सकते हैं, that is going to be the density of the gas. So let's see how are we going to measure the density. We know that density that is equal to mass upon volume. Therefore, volume that will become equal to mass upon density. ठीक है? अब यहाँ पे हमारे पास क्या आ रहा है कि P V that is a constant. Let's say that constant that is equal to K1. Okay? Putting the value of volume from here, P M upon D that is going to be equal to K1. So if you want to calculate density, तो density क्या आ जाएगी? PM upon K1, so you can calculate the density from here. Okay, is it clear? So constant temperature पे अगर आपको density calculate करनी है, K1 is given to you in the question, pressure is given to you in the question, mass of the gas is given, so you can easily calculate the density. Then there's another very important graphical representation which you will see. That is, if we are plotting a graph between PV and P, it is seen that the graph that comes as a straight line. Parallel to the axis where pressure is taken. ठीक है? क्योंकि वहाँ पे जब आपको options आएंगी, तो ये P यहाँ पे भी लिया जा सकता है. So if the P is taken on this axis, और PV जो है, that is taken over here, then your graph that is going to come like this. So the graph that should or the plot should be parallel to the axis where we are taking pressure. Okay? So this is the first law over here, which is known as the Charles law. Let's go on to the second, the Boyle's law. Let's go on to the second law, which is the Charles law. Okay? Ye yahan tak hame samajh aa gaya? Okay. Then third which we have, that is going to be the Charles law. Charles law क्या बोलता है कि अगर हम लोग pressure constant कर रहे हैं, then the volume of the gas that is going to be directly proportional to temperature. ठीक है? और we have another distinct expression for this, that is the V at time t, that the volume at time t that is equal to V naught plus into 1 plus T upon 273. ठीक है? But mostly हम लोग ये वाला expression use करते हैं. तो अगर हम ये वाला expression use कर रहे हैं, तो हमारे पास क्या आ गया? V upon T, that is a constant. Or we can say that V1 upon T1, that is equal to V2 upon T2. Right? So, जो आपके numericals आएंगे, they are going to come from this section. अब यहाँ पे एक और चीज हमको define करनी है, that what is absolute zero? Absolute zero is a hypothetical figure which is equal to zero Kelvin or it is equal to minus 273.15 degree Celsius. Okay? This is going to be the value of absolute zero. ये वो value होती है जहाँ पे it is seen or it is said that the volume of the gas that becomes equal to zero, which is not possible. So that is the reason why we say that this is going to be a hypothetical value. ठीक है? Now over here, if we plotting a graph between volume and temperature at constant pressure, then these graphs, they are said to be isobars, right? क्योंकि हम लोग constant temperature पे constant pressure पे इसको ले रहे हैं, so let's say if we have over here graphs which are extrapolating, they are reaching this value. Let's say this is P1, P2, P3 and P4. Now, in this case, the value of P1, ये उल्टा है उससे जो आपने Boyle's law में किया था, P1 that is going to be lesser than P2, lesser than P3, lesser than P4. Okay? So, ये भी आपको आ सकता है कि P की variables क्या होगी. So, you have to see that in isobars, जो आपका सबसे ऊपर वाला graph है, उसका pressure सबसे कम होगा, और जो सबसे नीचे वाला graph है, उसका pressure सबसे ज्यादा होगा. ठीक है? So this is the kya kehte hai usko, isobars which we have seen over here. Now what can be the practical significance of the Charles law? Hydrogen balloons jo hote hain, which are used for meteorological departments, that is going to be one of the applications of the Charles law. Theek hai? Third jo hamare paas law ab yahan pe aayega, that is going to be the Gay-Lussac's law, that is the pressure temperature relationship. So we'll write it here only. Now the Gay-Lussac's law jo hai, that is going to be at constant volume. So according to this law, pressure is directly proportional to T at constant volume. Theek hai? Or we can say that P1 upon T1, that is equal to P2 upon V2. Or iske jo hum graphs draw karte hain between pressure and temperature, these are known as isophores. Okay? The last law which we have over here, okay, then third which we have, that is going to be the Charles law. Charles law kya bolta hai ki agar hum log pressure constant kar rahe hain, then the volume of the gas, that is going to be directly proportional to temperature. Theek hai? Or we have another distinct expression for this, that is the V at time T, that the volume at time T, that is equal to V naught plus into 1 plus T upon 273. Theek hai? But mostly hum log ye wala expression use karte hain. To agar hum ye wala expression use kar rahe hain, to hamare paas kya aa gaya, V upon T, that is a constant. Or we can say that V1 upon T1, that is equal to V2 upon T2. Right? So, jo aapke numericals aayenge, they are going to come from this section. Ab yahan pe ek aur cheez humko define karni hai, that what is absolute zero? Absolute zero is a hypothetical figure which is equal to zero Kelvin or it is equal to minus 273.15 degree Celsius. Okay? This is going to be the value of absolute zero. Ye wo value hoti hai jahan pe it is seen or it is said that the volume of the gas that becomes equal to zero, which is not possible. So that is the reason why we say that this is going to be a hypothetical value. Theek hai? Now over here, if we're plotting a graph between volume and temperature at constant pressure, then these graphs, they are said to be isobars, right? Kyunki hum log constant temperature pe constant pressure pe isko le rahe hain. So let's say if we have over here graphs which are extrapolating, they are reaching this value. Let's say this is P1, P2, P3 and P4. Now in this case, the value of P1, ye ulta hai usse jo aapne Boyle's law mein kiya tha, P1 that is going to be lesser than P2, lesser than P3, lesser than P4. Okay? So ye bhi aapko aa sakta hai ki P ki variables kya hogi. So you have to see that in isobars, jo aapka sabse upar wala graph hai, uska pressure sabse kam hoga, aur jo sabse niche wala graph hai, uska pressure sabse zyada hoga. Theek hai? So this is the kya kehte hai usko, isobars which we have seen over here. Now what can be the practical significance of the Charles law? Hydrogen balloons jo hote hain, which are used for meteorological departments, That is going to be one of the applications of the Charles law. Okay? Third jo hamare paas law ab yahan pe aayega, that is going to be the Gay-Lussac's law. That is the pressure temperature relationship. So we'll write it here only. Now the Gay-Lussac's law जो है दैट इज गोइंग टू बी एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस लॉ प्रेशर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू टी एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. ठीक है, और यू कैन से दैट पी वन अपॉन टी वन दैट इज इक्वल टू पी टू अपॉन टी टू. और इसके जो हम ग्राफ्स ड्रॉ करते हैं between pressure and temperature, these are known as isophores. Okay, the last law which we have over here, that is going to be the Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law kya bolta hai ki at constant pressure and constant temperature, equal volumes of all gases, they are going to contain equal number of molecules. ठीक है, or in other words we can say that V over here that is equal to KN, right? And it also says that S and STP, each of the gas that is going to occupy equal volume, which is 22.4 liters, or it is equal to 22400 milliliters. ठीक है, so at STP the volume occupied by each gas, this is important, तो कितनी होनी चाहिए 22.4 liters. Now depending upon all the laws we can formulate the gas equation. The gas equation may be formulated in two ways. The first is P1 upon T1. That is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. ठीक है, combining all the laws. And the second one, that is equal to PV, that is equal to nRT, where R over here, that is going to be the gas constant. Is it clear? Okay. Now यहाँ पे एक और चीज आपने रखनी है कि जैसे हम STP भी बोल रहे हैं 22.4 liters है, तो अगर SATP conditions होती है तो उसमें हम 22.7 liters लेते हैं. ज्यादा कोई फर्क नहीं है, बट फिर भी यू शुड नो इट्स टेकन एज अप्रोक्सिमेटली 22.7 फॉर एनी आइडियल गैस, राइट? सो व्हेन वी डूइंग द गैस लॉ, वैसे तो आर की वैल्यू आपको जनरली दे रखी होती है, बट आर की वैल्यू जो होगी दैट इज गोइंग टू डिपेंड अपॉन व्हाट? इट विल डिपेंड अपॉन द यूनिट्स ऑफ द प्रेशर एंड वॉल्यूम. ठीक है, सो प्रेशर की हमें क्या यूनिट्स दी हुई है और वॉल्यूम की हमें क्या यूनिट्स दी है, उसके बेसिस पे आर का टेबल आपको लर्न होना चाहिए. सो वी टेकिंग द टेबल ओवर हियर, लेट्स से दैट द यूनिट ऑफ वॉल्यूम इज लीटर एंड द यूनिट ऑफ प्रेशर इज एटमॉस्फेयर. इन दैट केस द वैल्यू ऑफ आर दैट इज गोइंग टू बी टेकन एज 0.0821 लीटर एटमॉस्फेयर पर मोल पर केल्विन. ठीक है, नाउ इफ वी चेंज ओवर हियर टू मिलीलीटर एंड दिस इज एटमॉस्फेयर, देन द वैल्यू दैट विल बिकम एज व्हाट? 82.1 मिलीलीटर्स एटमॉस्फेयर पर मोल पर केल्विन. ठीक है, थर्ड हमारे पास क्या आ गया? लीटर. And we have over here bar. So in this case, the value will be taken as 0.0831 liter bar per mole per Kelvin. ठीक है? उसके बाद हमारे पास अगर हम इसको decimeter cube में ले लेते हैं, right? Decimeter cube and we are taking bar over here. So what is going to be the value then? Then it is going to be again the same, because 1 liter that is equal to 1 decimeter cube, right? So the value will be 0.0 831 decimeter cube bar per volt per Kelvin. If you're taking over here milliliters and you're taking over here bar, then what is going to be the value? It is going to be 83.1 milliliter bar per mole per Kelvin. ठीक है, और फिर उसके बाद अगर आपको जूल्स में दे रखी होती है वैल्यू, पास्कल्स में वैल्यू दे रखी है, या आपको आर की वैल्यू जूल्स में लेनी है, तो जूल्स में जो वैल्यू आती है दैट इज गोइंग टू बी 8.31 जूल्स पर मोल पर कैलोरी. और अगर यही वैल्यू हम कैलोरीज में लेते हैं तो इट इज 1.97 कैलोरीज पर मोल per Kelvin, which is approximately taken as 2. Okay, so aapki calculations ko better karne ke liye, the value over here that is going to be taken as 2. Samajh aa gaya? Okay, then let's go on to our ideal gas equation. PV that is equal to nRT. Ab isko hum log in terms of density agar hum karna chahe, to aapko pata hai ki what is number of moles, weight of the substance upon molecular mass, RT. ठीक है, यही आ जाएगा. What is going to be value of pressure, WRT upon V into M. ठीक है, now what is weight upon volume, what is going to be the weight upon volume, density. So weight upon volume, that is going to be density RT upon M. Now if you have to calculate the molar mass of any gas, so you can calculate the molar mass from here. Molar mass, that will be equal to DRT upon P. Have you understood? So is tarah se aap molar mass jo hai wo kisi bhi ek gas ka calculate kar sakte ho. Then we go on to the next law that is very very important, Dalton's law of partial pressure. Next है हमारा Dalton's law of partial pressure. Now according to the Dalton's law of partial pressure, you know that if we have taken a mixture of gases, then each of the gas that is going to exert a pressure by itself, such that the total pressure of the gas mixture, that is given as PA plus PB. Okay, where PA, that is going to be partial pressure of gas 1, and PB, that is going to be the partial pressure of gas B, right? Now, agar hum log PA aur PB ko in terms of number of moles, ek, ya in terms of number of, kya kehte, in terms of mole fraction ek expression dena chahe, to aap yahan pe PA upon P total, this is the expression which you are going to use, that is going to be equal to XA. P total aap in dono ka partial pressure se find kar sakte ho, aur PA, hamare paas PA upon P total, that is going to be equal to XA. Theek hai? Or in a similar manner, PB upon P total, that is going to be equal to XB. Theek hai? So this is the Dalton's law. Iski ek importance hoti hai, ya application hoti hai, to calculate the aqueous tension of water. Aqueous tension is the pressure of water. So if we have we have to calculate the pressure of oxygen, so that is going to be equal to P atmosphere minus the aqueous tension, which may also be written as minus PH2O. So PH2 over here, this is going to be aqueous tension. ठीक है? This is what is important over here, क्योंकि इसमें से आपको एक question हम लोग expect कर सकते हैं. Then we go on to, once we've done all the pressures, you know what the ideal gas equation is, you know what a non-ideal gas equation is. Ideal gas equation कौन सा होता है? Which is going to obey all the laws at all temperatures and pressures, or non-ideal jo hai, that is not going to obey, right? Now over here there's another important term which we are going to do, that is going to be the graphical representation of, you can say, the Boyle's law, or uske accordingly we are going to see over here one very important factor, which is the compressibility factor. ठीक है? So अगर हम लोग एक ideal gas ले, और हम एक ग्राफ प्लॉट कर रहे हैं बिटवीन पीवी एंड पी. ओके, नाउ इन दिस केस दिस इज द ग्राफ फॉर आइडियल गैस, बट वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट द गैसेस दे कैन नॉट बी आइडियल. सो देयरफॉर जो गैसेस लॉस को ऑबे नहीं करती उसको हम नॉन आइडियल गैसेस बुलाते हैं, या उसको हम क्या बुलाते हैं, रियल गैसेस. So real gases, they may have two types of deviations. One which is a positive deviations and the other one which is going to be the negative deviations. ठीक है? Now the deviations from the law, that is going to be suggested or that is going to be explained on the basis of a factor which is known as compressibility factor. This compressibility factor, that is given by Z. This factor tells us how much a gas can be compressed. ठीक है? So ये जो compressibility factor होता है Z, that is equal to PV upon nRT. An important expression, Z that is equal to PV upon nRT. Now remember that for ideal gases, the value of Z that is going to be equal to 1. Okay, number 1, this is the first condition. The second condition is, if the value of Z that is greater than 1, then the gases, they are going to show positive deviations from the ideal gas behavior and they are going to be less compressible. ठीक है? And if the third condition which we have is, if the value of Z is less than 1, they are going to show negative deviation over here and the gases, they are going to be more compressible. ठीक है? तो अगर Z की वैल्यू 1 है तो गैस इज एन आइडियल गैस, अगर Z की वैल्यू ग्रेटर देन 1 है तो दे आर पॉजिटिव डिविएशंस, एज यू कैन सी फॉर दीज टू ग्राफ्स ओवर हियर फॉर हाइड्रोजन एंड हीलियम. लेट्स से दिस इज द ग्राफ फॉर कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड दिस इज द ग्राफ फॉर CH4. नेगेटिव डिविएशंस के लिए द वैल्यू ऑफ Z इज लेस देन 1 एंड दीज गैसेस दे आर गोइंग टू बी मोर कंप्रेसिबल. राइट, नाउ ओवर हियर यू हैव स्टडीड दैट एवरी गैस मॉलिक्यूल दैट इज मूविंग. सो अगर हर एक गैस मॉलिक्यूल मूव कर रहा है तो उनके पास काइनेटिक एनर्जी भी होनी चाहिए. ठीक है? ईच गैस मॉलिक्यूल इन एनी गैस दैट इज गोइंग टू मूव विद डिफरेंट स्पीड्स. तो मैक्सवेल ने अपना एक मैक्सवेल बोल्ट्जमैन ने एक रिलेशनशिप दिया था बिटवीन द डिफरेंट स्पीड्स. ठीक है? सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आर दीज डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्पीड्स, बिकॉज इसमें से भी हमको एक न्यूमेरिकल आ सकता है. If we're looking at the different kind of speeds over here, we have the first one which is known as the most probable speed, which is given by UMB. This most probable speed, that is the speed possessed by maximum fraction of molecules in a gas. ठीक है? That is why the name most probable. The second type of speed which we have, that is known as the average speed. Which is UAV. ये जो average speed होती है, if there are n number of molecules, so U average, that is going to be equal to the speed of each of the molecules which is present in a gas divided by the total number of molecules n. ठीक है? Or you can also take over here if there are number of moles which are present. ठीक है, एक ही जैसे एक गैस है उसमें एक कोई भी पार्टिकल्स जो है, say 10 particles they are having the same speed. ठीक है, so in that case alternatively U average can be found as N1 U1 plus N2 U2 plus N2 U3 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3 and so on. Then the next one which we have, the most important, that is the root mean square velocity. Which is denoted by URMS. Okay, so URMS aapka kya ho gaya? Root mean square. Root mean square matlab ab humne under root lena hai U1 and we have to take the mean also divided by N. ठीक है, and alternatively you can also use root mean square है, sorry square कर लेना इसको. Alternatively you can also calculate this as plus N3. Got it? So this is how you can calculate the root mean square velocity. Now the important part over here is कि हम इस root mean square velocity या जितने भी हमने types of speeds करे हैं, इनको हम correlate कर सकते हैं with temperature and molar mass of the gas. इसमें से आपको इन expression में से question आता है, तो ये expressions आपने learn करके रखने हैं. जैसे for example, if we are taking UMP, that is equal to under root of 2RT upon M. Right? Where M, that is going to be equal to molar mass. These are the expressions you need to learn over here. Then average speed under root of 8RT upon pi M. Okay? And root mean square velocity, that is equal to under root of 3RT upon M. Right? Now, if we're taking a ratio of all of these, the ratio of UMP is to U average is to URMS, that is equal to 1 is to 1.128 is to 1.224. Okay, तो इसका मतलब कि जो URMS है, that has the greatest value, फिर उसके बाद UAV and we have UMB. ठीक है, so ये वाले expression आपकी competition point of view से important है, इनको आपने अच्छे से learn करके रखना है. Right, so we've done the compressibility factor over here. Then the last topic which we are going to do today, that is going to be the van der Waals equation. Now, van der Waals ne aapko pata hai sari detail ki ideal gas jo thi, wo ideal gases ki tarah behave kyu nahi karti hai? Kyu wo real gases ki tarah behave karti hai? To van der Waals ne bola ki jo kinetic theory of gases bolti hai, uspe do assumptions jo the wo faulty the. ठीक है, first assumption क्या कि there is going to be no forces of attraction between the molecules of a gas, right? So he said if there are no forces of attraction with respect to the molecules of the gas, तो gases कभी भी compress नहीं हो सकती, liquefy नहीं हो सकती, ठीक है? So उसने वहाँ पे एक correction term दिया. Second assumption was that the volume of the molecule, that is negligible as compared to the total volume of the gas. ये भी बोला था ना काइनेटिक थ्योरी ने. तो अगर ऐसा भी होता तो क्या होता, तब तो जीरो केल्विन पे जो वॉल्यूम होनी चाहिए गैस की वो कितनी हो जानी चाहिए, शुड बी जीरो, बट दैट आल्सो डज नॉट हैपन, इजंट इट? सो ही गिव अस टू करेक्शन टर्म्स, द वॉल इज गोइंग टू गिव अस टू करेक्शन टर्म्स, वन व्हिच इज करेक्शन टर्म ए व्हिच वाज द करेक्शन टर्म ड्यू टू And the second one, B, which was due to the volume of the molecule. Now he said that jo volume hoti hai molecule ki, that is equal to 4 times the original molecule of the gas. Why was that? Because wo jab expand karta hai, so it is attracting the molecules around. Therefore, the actual volume of actual molecule has a volume 4 times the original volume of a molecule. And that was known as what? That was known as the covolume. Now, over here, depending upon these forces of attraction, the correction term or the new expression was given for the ideal, or you can say for the real gas behavior or the real gas equation, which was given as P plus AN square upon V square into V minus NB, that is equal to NRT. This was for N number of moles. And if you're calculating this for one mole, then it is P upon A, P plus A upon V square, V minus V, that is going to be equal to RT. ठीक है? So significance, A का क्या हो जाएगा? ये भी बहुत important है, conceptual question. A हमें क्या दे रहा है? The correction due to forces of attraction. Greater the value of A, more easily a gas can be liquefied. ठीक है? अगर A की value ज़्यादा होती है, तो gas ज़्यादा easily liquefy होती है. This you have to remember. So इसमें आपको 4-5 gases दे देंगे, उसमें A की value दे रखी होगी, और आपको question आ सकता है कि which of the following that is going to be most liquefiable. ठीक है? So जिसकी A की value ज़्यादा होती है, उसमें liquefication ज़्यादा होती है. Now depending upon this, we come to the critical phenomenon of a gas. जैसे हम liquefaction of a gas कर रहे हैं, तो आपको अगर याद है, तो liquefaction of gas के लिए Andrews ने एक carbon dioxide के को लेके curve दिया था. ठीक है? वो curve हमको detail में नहीं पढ़ना है, but we have to study the critical phenomena. क्या है ये critical phenomena? According to Andrews, at one particular temperature, the gases, they can be liquefied. Now, what is these critical points where the gases, they can be liquefied? The first one that is known as critical temperature. ठीक है? Critical temperature को हम denote करते हैं by TC. We know that क्या होता है critical temperature? The temperature above which a gas cannot be liquefied, that is going to be the critical temperature. ठीक है? तो जिसका critical temperature high होगा, जैसे for example, if we take carbon dioxide, so carbon dioxide that has a critical temperature of approximately 304.15 Kelvin, so it can be easily liquefied. ठीक है? उसी तरह से अगर हम hydrogen का लेते हैं, तो hydrogen का is only 33.2, it cannot be easily liquefied. तो जिनके critical temperature ज़्यादा होते हैं, those are the gases which can be easily liquefied. And in terms of A and B, the value of TC, that is equal to (8A/27RB). Right? फिर उसके बाद second हमारे पास क्या आता है? Critical pressure. क्या हुआ critical pressure? The pressure of the gas at critical temperature, that is going to be the critical pressure. And critical pressure that is given as (A/27B²). ठीक है? And third is going to be the critical volume. Kya hui critical volume? It is denoted by VC, the volume occupied by a gas at critical temperature and critical pressure, which is given by 3B. where A and B they are going to be van der Waals constants. Okay? So this is what we have over here. The second state of matter which we are going to do, that is the liquid state of matter. Usme kuch zyada hai nahi. You know the terms, what is evaporation, what is vapor pressure, you know what viscosity is, you know what surface tension is. So these are the terms which you need to study from there. But major hum log jo karenge, that is the questions they are going to surround around the topics which we have discussed. Now, liquid state wala, you can just go through your NCRT. That's all theoretical concept. So, ek bari aap bahut easy usme phenomenon hai. So, that I am not going to discuss with you. Theek hai?